Seattle, Kansas City, Seattle.
You're looking inside the Orleans Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada. Our matchup, the Seattle U Redhawks taking on the UMKC Kangaroos. Hello, everyone. Thank you for watching this WAC Digital Network presentation, along with former NBA player Stephen Hunter. My name is Michael Clanton. Welcome to the 2015 WAC Tournament Semifinals. The winner to face the number one overall seed, New Mexico State, that just won moments ago here.
Absolutely. This has been a great tournament so far. Two well-matched teams here. It's going to be a great game. Interesting to see how this unfolds. Whoever wins have a tough task with New Mexico State tomorrow night.
Without question. Let's begin first, though, with Seattle U. They come off a scrappy Chicago State win. This team, it was tough, and they're led by Isaiah Umepig. Without them, they would have lost.
I mean, this guy is just outstanding last night against Chicago State, coming up with some big shots against the scrappy team. He's their heart and soul. He's going to need to continue upon that great game he had last night because they're going to need each and every point today.
And how about for UMKC? First conference tournament win since 2007. They beat a depleted Bronx team, and they had a great contribution from Holiday, who scored 18 points in that game.
Yeah, Reese Holiday is just extremely versatile. Doing different things there, just defensively, offensively. They expect a lot out of him. He's an outstanding player, a little undersized, but as you see there, just inside, outside threat, hook shots, three-point shots. I mean, the guy can do it all. They're going to need him in order to be successful tonight.
Without question. All right, we're about set to go. You're watching the WAC Digital Network. When we come back, tip-off between Seattle U and UMKC. Back to the Orleans Arena after this.
Damn it, bro.
It all comes down to this. 14 teams battle their way through the bracket for a chance to punch their ticket to the big dance. Be a part of the madness in Las Vegas, March 11th to 14th. Go all in and witness who goes home a champion at Orleans Arena. The 2015 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. Tickets on sale now at OrleansArena.com.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that.
Well, did you know certain cartoon characters should never have an energy drink?
Action.
Geico.
Welcome back inside the Orleans. Let's check in now with a third member of our team, Evan Murray.
I talked to Seattle U's head coach Cameron Dollar, and he said that there's two keys to this game: attack the zone and contain UMKC's two guards, WAC Player of the Year Martez Harrison and Deshaun Taylor. Guys.
All right, thank you, Evan. That Taylor had a terrific game against Texas Pan American, 16 points.
Keys for Seattle U is, they want to get off to a good start, take any confidence away from this Kansas City team.
Well, that's a good start.
That's a very good shot.
That's one of the top players in the conference. He simply did not want to go home.
He did.
And he willed that team to beat Chicago State. And Chicago State, we were just so impressed with their effort. And it really took everything Seattle U had to get past the Cougars. And, boy, Umepig just was terrific in that game.
Great matchup here between Umepig and Martez Harrison, the WAC Player of the Year. This should be a good matchup. Two great guards going at it tonight.
Thaddeus Smith tied up on the possession. It'll stay with UMKC. Martez Harrison, the WAC Player of the Year. One of the top scorers in the conference, the top scorer in the conference, I should say, just a sophomore, already has scored 1,000 points, has an outside chance to become UMKC's all-time leading scorer. He has two more productive years like the first two have been. He was also, I believe, freshman of the year in the conference last season. Wow. And Taylor drains a three.
Wow, great ball movement early on from Kansas City. Finding a great shot, passing up good shots for a great shot. A beautiful shot, knocked down by Taylor.
Murray on the reverse was fouled.
You see there, Kansas City a little aggressive with their half-court trap, allowing Murray to get the ball on the baseline, going in for a reverse layup. Foul by Thaddeus Smith.
Emerson Murray, Cameron Dollar, and we spoke with him, I guess, a couple days ago. This is our 10th game, so
yeah.
It all kind of blurs together. Cameron Dollar, though, was sensational with us, and he's just so proud of his team. And he said, this is not just a one-year thing. This has been in the making for years.
Absolutely.
To be able to get to this point. I caught the end of his presser last night, and he was just so proud of his seniors. As Crook almost knocked it in, but did miss it, and UMKC now with possession.
Great teacher of the game. Told me the other day, as long as he's working with kids, he's happy. Just loves being around the game. And a head coach, since he was 22 years old, starting his head coaching career. So plenty of experience from Cameron Dollar.
Yeah, coached at a NAIA school just outside of Los Angeles. He corrected me. I said 22. He said, no, I was 21.
Wow.
At the time.
21.
So he went into coaching at a very young age. His dad is a legendary coach in the South. And so he knew what he wanted to be. He was one of the great players at UCLA back in the late 90s with the run that those Bruins teams had. Turnover here, 4-3 early. UMKC trailing as we play 2 minutes here in this first half. The winner will face New Mexico State in the finals. That'll be on ESPNU at 8 o'clock Pacific time.
Kansas City got a lot of production out of Reese Holiday last game. Would like to see Flora have a better game this game. They're really going to need his offense, his shooting ability.
The shot clock was at 2, rebound by Murray. These two teams, incidentally, they split the season series, each winning at home. Yuma pick for 3, hit the first one of the game. Does he get the bounce? He does not. But Pell gets the rebound back to Yuma pick. And what are they going to say? It touched the shot clock.
Yeah, I think it touched the shot clock.
So it will be UMKC basketball. Isaiah Yuma pick is Isaac Kruer, the 6'10", 245-pound sophomore center out of Harrisonville, Missouri. Comes back into the ball game. Did start a few games. And some injuries has UMKC. Here is Harrison on the runner. Going to be called on the offensive foul. Couldn't stop in time.
Again, he has to learn how to stop and shoot that floater over the defense. If you look at some of the top point guards at the next level, they set themselves up by going into the lane, but they're able to stop on a dime and shoot a floater and not run into the defender for an offensive foul.
UMKC, they want to turn it over.
Great
big
pass.
Time as Powell throws it down. William Powell, the sophomore out of Alabama.
Wow, very, very aggressive move. Way to run the floor for Powell. Catching the ball first, going up strong for the finish.
6-3 our score early on here in the first half.
2-3 zone for Seattle U. Trying to establish a defensive identity in this game.
Harrison missed it. Crook with the rebound.
Okay, Martez Harrison just a little off to start this game. He needs to settle down. He's going to need one of those 30-point games if Kansas City is going to be successful tonight. He needs to really come out of his shooting slump and give his team a big boost today.
Oh, nice pass. Yuma picked a Crook, and it falls in for the big fella. 6'11". 265 pounds and of the Manchester, UK.
I was watching him and shoot around. Great footwork, soft hands around the bucket. Practices well. Hopefully he can get off to a good start.
Frank Williams Jr. connects on the long ball and brings the Kangaroos to within 2.
Both teams starting to settle into the game. Get all the nervous energy out, knock down some shots, get some confidence. Should be a good one today.
Here's Flora. You talked about it. You'd like to see him be a little bit more productive this game.
I would. They're going to need Flora to be aggressive. You know, in the regular season, he was a big piece of what they did. Kind of disappeared a little bit in this conference tournament so far. Going to need him to have a good one today. They want to be successful.
He had 7 points and 3 rebounds. Murray missed on the 3, and Murray hit the clinching free throws and had the key defensive play. Was it last night? I guess it was last night against Chicago State. As Williams Jr. hit the 3 moments ago, but misses that baseline jumper. And Crook, you know, we talked about he had the last bucket for Seattle. Much improved over a season ago. Coach Duller really likes how far he's come as Yuma Pig knocks in another three.
Nice shot by Yuma Pig, stepping into that three-point shot with confidence. Off to a great start here for Seattle U. Up 11-6 after the first 5 minutes in the first half.
Yuma Pig had 17 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and 4 steals in the win against the Cougars. Holiday. Boy, he was active in the Texas Pan American game. And a nice start here, easy two.
Great move by Holiday. Using the baseline, coming out of the corner, slashing to the basket, passing up an open three-point shot to go to the lane, establish his aggressiveness on the offensive end.
Again, had 18 in the quarterfinal win against Texas Pan American. Also 8 rebounds. We're going to have a foul on Martez Harrison, the WAC Player of the Year.
So far, great effort from both teams, but if see Seattle U here get out for the Thunder Dump.
Good sportsmanship isn't defined by a scoreboard.
It isn't defined by how high you jump or how fast you can run.
Good sportsmanship is all about character.
It is about doing your best for your coaches and teammates.
It is about having respect for your opponents, the officials, and the fans.
Good sportsmanship is winning with class and losing with dignity.
It's fair play, perseverance, and team spirit.
Good sportsmanship is what unites us.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
People talk about college like you're in some kind of bubble. Like there's college and then there's the real world. Hey, this is UVU. You're not just reading about it or watching someone else do it. This is engaged learning. At the certificate, associates, bachelor's, or master's level, you're in the real world every day.
Our score, 13:48 left. Isaiah Yuma Pig, the senior from Seattle, off to a nice start here in this first half in the semifinal game.
Absolutely, 6 points on 2 3-point shots. There you go, stepping into the shot, shooting it with confidence, letting everybody know, hey, that was a 3-point shot. And just playing with a lot of confidence. They're going to need him to step up early on, and he's a big reason why they're up 11-8. Here with 13:48 left in the first half.
He's a transfer from Fullerton at a Federal Way Washington. They call him Zeke. First team all WAC. Out of the timeout, Seattle U starts with a possession.
Kansas City made some substitutions. They're a very deep team. Looks like they're going with a whole new five. Out there, except for number 54.
Yuma Pig that time off the mark on the three. He's got 2 made threes. Out of bounds, UMKC basketball. Broderick Newbill is coming to the ball game for the first time for Coach Kareem Richardson. Played at Evansville, was a Purple Ace. Graduated back in 97. Was tutored by some pretty good coaches too, Rick Pitino.
Yes.
As well as Marvin Menzies.
Absolutely. Carries the same culture, aggressive, in your face, up tempo defense. Try to press the whole game. He steals, easy runouts.
He's in his second year at UMKC, and they have the 2 seed for the second time in program history. Jennings is checked in. Underneath, Powell with a deflection, and staying with it was the aforementioned Roderick Newbill, 6'5", 195-pound sophomore out of Kansas City, Missouri, a transfer from Fresno State.
Great hustle, Great determination around the basket. Made a great play. Give his team 2 points.
Newbill's dad actually played for UMKC on their first Division I team back in 1987. Yumapig again from distance.
Ooh. That was in and out. Yumapig feeling it early on.
Borgos checked back into the game for Seattle U. Rebound here by Kohi. He had a nice game against Chicago State.
Right now you see Kansas City in their zone. Vulnerable for 3-point shots, fortunate enough to get the miss there. Good defense by Kansas City, forcing Seattle U to jump shots now. You see Yumapig turning a little bit three happy. He missed his. Now another miss right here. Kansas City with the ball with enough time to capitalize and build on this lead.
Chebago with the foul, his first personal. CLU now one of their last five. And UMKC a chance to take the lead. Newbill rims out, rebound by Murray.
Here Kansas City looks like they're in a 1-3-1 zone. Trying to switch defenses up on Seattle U, confuse them a little bit.
And a turnover. It did confuse it.
It did.
Coach Richardson able to force the turnover with that defense.
Coach
force 18, 19, 20 turnovers if they can.
Absolutely. Coach Richardson switching up defenses, confusing Seattle U. Great job by both teams. Got a close one early on.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that.
Well, did you know that words really can hurt you?
Jesse, don't go!
Geico.
They come for one of the nation's top-rated business schools, the world-class performing arts, the advances in engineering and health science, and more than 125 leading degree programs. Their paths to success go in many directions, but they all start here. UMKC, the place for people going places.
They are the dreamers and the promise of the future. They are the hope who will lead us to tomorrow. They are the givers who have the passion to serve. They are the visionaries who will celebrate discovery. They will make a difference. They will change South Texas.
The 10, Seattle U leading UMKC. Let's check in now with Evan.
Yeah, Cameron Dollar said he'd like to see his team attack the zone a little bit more and to get open looks inside. Back to you guys.
Okay, see if they can do that here in the next 11-19. Just turning it over moments ago. But they do have a 1-point lead against UMKC. And for the Kangaroos, they have really struggled on offense, scoring the basketball throughout the season, but so far, not too bad within striking distance here. If we look at Coach Dollar.
Thank you. Seattle, you doing a good job of playing team basketball, working the ball around. As long as they don't get too three happy working against this Kansas City zone, they can find some success attacking the gaps and trying to get to the basket for easy buckets.
Knight. Noah Knight from the outside. Crook with the rebound.
Great defense there by Seattle U. Keeping Kansas City out of the paint, forcing a tough jump shot.
Crook. Flora open looking at a three, and he got it to go.
There's Flora finally establishing a rhythm there. Rhythm jump shot, catching the ball. Sweet stroke. Great bucket for him.
Jarrell Flores, senior out of Bremerton, Washington, put on 20 pounds of muscle in the offseason. One of the old-timers there at Seattle U. Nice look inside in the flush by Newbill.
Great energy by this second unit for Kansas City. Doing a great job for Coach Richardson's staff. Coming in the game with energy, playing hard defense.
Yumapig for three. He's got his third.
He's feeling it. He's saying, what can I do? What can I say? You know?
He turns around with his palms up in the air saying, it's too easy.
Great job by Yumapig, taking the open shot, being aggressive, trying to be the leader of the team today.
You mentioned he plays with a lot of confidence. He's displayed that so far early.
Yes, he has.
Austin lost it.
Now, the offensive end is where Kansas City struggles, especially against this team out of home. And try to get some stops on this end to create some easy runouts and layups, because Kansas City is going to struggle in the half court today playing against this tough zone of Seattle U.
I mean, they have locked in defensively in certain games this season, holding teams to 31 points, 33 points, 35 points. So when they have it going, it is really hard to score against the Redhawks.
And they don't have Brooke. They don't have the most size, but they play with five smart players on the floor that's good at following directions and getting to their spots defensively.
Yumapig missed on the three. Powell battles.
Great
for
hustle by Powell.
Flora had just hit a three moments ago. Back-to-back threes by Jarrell Flora.
And great look from Flora. Yumapig and Flora knocking down threes, playing defense on this end. They're giving themselves a shot to pull away this first half. Kansas City searching for answers.
Can UMKC keep up offensively? That is a major storyline, in my opinion, in this game. They just struggle so much on this offensive end.
Absolutely. And then on the offensive end, we have Yumapig getting wide open like this. You know, nine times out of ten, he's going to hit that shot. You know, with their defense, their zone, we've seen how they totally stopped Chicago State in the second half with this tough zone. They play their positions so well. And here's another three here by Flora. You know, they have two great shooters out there at all times here with Yumapig and Flora. Just doing an outstanding job of finding open guys, getting stops on the defensive end, and creating points on the offensive end. Great job so far by Seattle U, up 20-12 here in the second part of the first half.
Yumapig 9 points, Flora with six, all of them courtesy of the three ball. Looking at UMKC, so Harrison, the WAC player of the year, so far 0-for-2, scoreless, and Holiday just 2 points after he scored 18 in the win against Texas Pan American.
Well, they're going to need Harrison's driving ability. He needs to find a way to attack this zone. With this zone, Seattle U likes to keep you out beyond the three-point line. But a quick player like Harrison can do just that and get in. He just has to finish.
And a couple of nice looks at it for UMKC. And boy, those have got to go down for them to stay in this game. Daddy Smith also had a nice look.
Absolutely. Harrison has to find a way not to get frustrated. This is a great move. He just has to have the ability to finish that. They're going to need him to step up big in this game. Got to knock it down.
Taylor.
Great defense by Seattle U. You see how stingy the zone is, not allowing Kansas City to get in the gaps. Right now, they're stuck shooting three-point shots.
Holiday inside, and that won't fall. Smith somehow able to get possession back to the Kangaroos.
Great rebound by Smith.
8-point lead. Harrison was blocked by Crook. Ball still free, and Williams Jr. able to come up with it. They are able to get some rebounds. Harvey lost it on the drive. Crook and Powell too much. Oh, and a casual pass by Flora. Almost a disaster for Seattle U.
Seattle U just with the clinic down here on zone defense, showing teams how to play, how to get to your spots. Watching them play a zone is a thing of beauty.
Yuma Pig made another three. He's got four.
Well-coached team by Cameron Dollar, getting his shooters running off screens. They're getting wide open looks, and they're knocking them down today. They didn't make shots last game against Chicago State that allowed Chicago State to get an early lead. Now these guys are making stops, and they're locked into their zone defense early in this game.
I mean, Seattle U, they were stunned. They trailed by 14 points in the first half, and they were looking around like, uh-oh. And it took a great effort for them to come back. Yuma Pig with the save to Powell.
They did. Kansas City has to watch out. They have to find ways to get into that zone. Right now, it's bothering them. And with Seattle, the more they stop you, the more confidence they get. So Kansas City needs to find answers, and they need to find answers fast.
A 12-2 run now by the Redhawks. Well, they are playing with a ton of confidence on both ends of the court. Yuma Pig.
There he is again. Look at
him. Five threes in the first half.
I mean,
he has outscored the Kangaroos by himself.
He's outstanding right now at this point. He's playing like he should have been the WAC Player of the Year. Kansas City needs Harrison to step up, show his dominance, and show why he was voted WAC Player of the Year. Great pass there for Harrison.
And finally, Frank Williams Jr. knocks down the three. The senior from Kansas City stopped a 15-2 run that the Redhawks were on, fueled by Yuma Pig.
Yuma Pig just feeling that he's unconscious right now, getting the dish, shooting it from wherever he touched it. Wow, all net, corner three here, pump fake, let it ride. He's unconscious. Seattle up by 11.
Christian education with the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu/value.
26-15 our score, 5:38 left. This semifinal matchup with UMKC, and Yuma Pig has stolen the show away from anybody else. He's the top headline right now with five made threes.
He's feeling it. They're going to have to come out of that zone and go to a man-to-man to try to keep him from getting so many open shots. As you see here, Coach Richardson has him in a man-to-man. Right away, Cameron Dollar goes to a screen and roll versus that man.
Offensive foul is going to be called.
Offensive foul to get Yuma Pig jumping in the air, trying to make a decision. Great defense by Kansas City.
5:17 left. Call a timeout here. 26-15 our score. Redhawks on top. Redhawks shooting by Yuma Pig and company. We'll take it with them. 26-15 Seattle U.
Canyon University provides a private Christian education with the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu/value.
Discover something new at New Mexico State University, where students find themselves, who they are, and what they want to be. Find new champions, new experiences, new challenges, new opportunities and horizons. What will you discover at NMSU? Dedicated professors, the perfect college experience. Make lifelong friends and lasting memories. New Mexico State University, all about discovery. Apply today at nmsu.edu. That's nmsu.edu.
Huh. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I know that.
Well, did you know that former pro football player Icky Woods will celebrate almost anything?
44.
Woo! 44, that's me!
Get some cold cuts.
Geico.
Cold cuts. Get some cold cuts.
26-15 our score. The Red Hawks leading UMKC. They split the season series. Both teams winning on their own home court. And after that sluggish start in the quarterfinals by Seattle U, they have vaulted ahead here in the semis. And a lot of work here for Kareem Richardson to try to figure out how to defend Yumapig and these perimeter shooters of the Red Hawks.
I see what stands out to me right now. Martez Harrison, 0-for-4, only 1 3-point attempt. He needs to get going in this game to try to give Kansas City some offense. Right now they're struggling. They're struggling against the zone, and he's going to be a big reason that they get back in the game if they do. But right now he's going to have to watch from the bench.
Inside, nice look, unable to finish with Smith.
Looks like he might have got fouled there, but no call by the referee.
Kohee. Here's Murray. Under 5 minutes to play in this opening half. Getting inside, here's Powell. Surrounded by Kangaroos. Nice defense. There's Noah having a hard time with it. Gets it to Jennings.
Great defense by Kansas City.
And then Newville just lost the dribble, and Murray was right there. It's those little things that they're not, I don't know, focused or detail or whatever. They're just making uncharacteristic mistakes now.
At this point in the game, down 11, you can't turn the ball over. Each possession is important. Here he is again.
6 3-pointers by Yumapig.
It's too easy. Right now, the rim is the size of an ocean, and he's just throwing a beach ball in the ocean right now. He's in the zone. He's locked in. 6 threes. I mean, unbelievable shooting performance we're witnessing right here from Yumapig.
He's got a season-high 33 points against UC Davis. Right now with 18 is Murray. With the rebound,
Kansas City needs to regroup. Still early in the game, you know. Right now, we're seeing guys with their head down. A lot of basketball to play.
Murray, Tibogo, able to knock down the jumper.
Everyone making shots right now. That's Tibogo down there. Measuring it up from the top of the key, knocking it down.
31-15, Newville surrounded back outside. Taylor, nice take. Left it short, though. I think that's kind of the right mindset, is to be aggressive and to drive it. What I would like to see from UMKC is energy.
Yes. Yeah, we just don't see that energy tonight. I believe that zone has frustrated KC.
Serious? 7 threes in the first half.
Are you serious? Are you serious?
What a performance by Isaiah Yumapig.
Are you serious?
The senior out of Federal Way, Washington.
Wow, he's having the game of his life. Sitting here witnessing this. Seattle U up 34-15. All on this man's back. Yumapig with another big three, 7 for 7. Wow.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
A 23-5 run over the last 8 minutes. And Isaiah Umapig putting on a shooting clinic. 7 of 11 from downtown, 21 points.
Wow.
That is impressive.
Young man is on fire right now.
And UMKC in a deep, deep hole. Murray deflects it out of bounds. 2:32 left, and it's all Seattle U so far, leading 34-15. And we'll come back, finish the first half after this.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
For years, Chicago State University has been committed to academic excellence. The conveniently located campus is affordable, accredited, boasts a 15-to-1 student-to-faculty ratio, graduates the largest number of African Americans attending Illinois public universities, and offers a variety of academic programs, including our renowned College of Pharmacy. We also have an outstanding NCAA Division I athletics program. To apply, visit csu.edu.
Our score, 2.5.
This copyrighted telecast.
To play here in the first half. And so far, it has been Isaiah Umapig's world. We're all just living in it as we have a look at some of the threes.
Absolutely. Seven times. All these threes he's making here. I mean, 7 3-point shots in the first half. He's just on fire. Has a beautiful stroke. Shooting it with confidence, getting excellent screens from his teammates. There's a pump fake. Kansas City's frustrated. Really, how can you guard this? You know, he's getting balls, pulling up, and letting it ride. I mean, absolutely beautiful performance early on by Umapig.
Harrison trying to answer and cannot as the Umapig comes up with the rebound. I'm trying to think, and I've seen a few games in my day, but I'm trying to think of another performance quite like this with 7 made threes in the first half.
Great performance. I mean, he's getting open. Kansas City, oh, great steal by Martez.
Hurry back defensively. Martez can't finish.
Problem
rebound
is
fought for, still free. Flora comes up with it. Still loose. Crook. Yeah, what's the call here? They're going to say a held ball. Timeout taken by Seattle U. Now a little bit of shoving after the play.
Frustration setting in now for Kansas City. Can't buy buckets, struggling in the half court, getting anything versus this Seattle U zone. And then on the other end, can't stop Seattle U from scoring the ball. So, I mean, just frustration setting in. They're going to have to find a way to try to get back in this game, get this lead down maybe to 10 or 9 before halftime and try to get some confidence going into the second half. We still got a lot of basketball to play.
Their strength is their defense.
Yes.
Their strength is turning you over and setting up that defense and getting everything in a frenzy, and they just have not been able to do that so far with this Red Hawks team.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's nerves, but I've seen a cooler Kansas City team today, playing very passive. I don't know if it's nerves, but not playing with that same energy and effort on the defensive end. Here, I don't see guys talking and flying around like they did in the quarterfinals.
Crook needs some help. Big man putting it on the floor, and does he get the floor? He does somehow. Not exactly how you brought up. Well, that would have been from 35. Crook.
Oh, look at Crook getting harassed.
He's got to get the ball out of his hand.
Mark says he needs to go up strong.
And he does draw the foul. You got a feel for him. He has not had a great tournament thus far. He's the WAC Player of the Year. And it just has not gone well for him so far.
Here has the steal. Don't worry about the contact. The refs will do their job. His job is to go up and try to make the layup. I think right now he's waiting on the contact, hoping and wishing for a foul. He needs to make the layup and then worry about calls later.
He had 43 consecutive games with double-figure scoring. That was broke on Valentine's Day. But the top scorer in the conference makes good on the first.
He's a guy that confidence back. Get a few shots to fall for him. He can fill it up in a hurry. They just need to try to find a way to keep this game manageable and stay in it so they have an opportunity in the second half to come back.
Harrison misses the second. So that made free throw on the first attempt, first point of the game for the WAC top scorer, Umapig. And he's fouled from behind by Deshaun Taylor, the freshman out of Riverside, California. Umapig will take a seat on the bench, boy.
Wow.
That is some shooting exhibition. Seven made threes in the first half.
Couldn't ask for a better start if you Seattle. You'd be up 34-16, minute left, going into the half. You're putting yourself in a great position to put this game away in the second half.
Flora missed on the three, but got his own miss. And a whistle and a foul on UMKC.
I mean, just look at the... I mean, here, just look at the shooting percentage here for Kansas City. 6 for 23, 26% field goal percentage, 37% from three-point range. You can't win that way, Mike.
Unless you can force 20 turnovers, which that's been their whole plan this year. The offense just hasn't been there.
Oh, there's a turnover.
And we'll lead the points. It will, is Deshaun Taylor. And he is a huge key. Deshaun Taylor has to come up with steals in this game for Coach Richardson's team to be successful.
Yes, he's a big part of the defense. Long, rangy player, active hands, great at getting steals here. As you see here, reaches in there, playing a passing lane, able to speed the ball up the court, drive in for the running layup. Great job, great effort by Deshaun Taylor.
That is just something that that's the way this team functions.
Yes.
And I'm sure some offensive punches will be coming via recruiting here coming up this in the offseason. But Coach Richardson, he knows the deal. He knows it has been frustrating on the offensive end.
Absolutely. When you rely so much on Martez Harrison, sitting here as we speak, 0 for 6 field goals with only 1 point. I mean, you got the WAC Player of the Year, the star player here in the semifinals. You know, you just got to have a better performance from Martez Harrison.
Both teams have dealt with some injury issues throughout the season.
There's that trapping zone, very aggressive from Kansas City.
But what I'm liking from UMKC, I'm seeing the body language. They do seem to be a little bit more energized, a little bit more involved after that.
Yes, yes. Coach Richardson group realizing they're down a bunch, trying to finish this first half off strong.
Look at this alignment. Effective there by Cameron Dollar. Gets it to Umapig. Does he have one more in him?
I'm sure he had one before the game is over.
Down to 15 seconds.
But if we can see one here before the half.
Yumapig.
Oh, great block.
Swung out of bounds by Smith.
Wow. Great block by him. Now Kansas City starting to pick their defense up. Shot clock is turned off. Seattle U's going to try to take the last shot, but great job as a big man here, tracking the ball down, recovering. Get that shot out of here, he says.
Yumapig does give it up. 5 seconds. Flora down to three.
They got to shoot it. Here's Flora. Good block. Great defense by Kansas City to end the half.
And what do you say? It's hard for a player to play with the lead. You just naturally kind of let off that aggression.
You do. You do. And that's the wrong thing to do versus this Kansas City team, who in the second half, I'm sure, is going to come out with even more aggressive defense trying to get back in this game.
34-18 our score as we head to break. We're going to hear from Cameron Dollar here in a few moments. And let's send it to Evan with Coach Cameron Dollar.
Hey, Coach. I mean, your team's losing much more themselves today. How refreshing is it to see that?
Well, you know what? Other than how we started, I thought we were ourselves yesterday, too. So it's good to come out. Obviously, we've hit some shots and was able to get up a good lead. But it's a long way from over.
It's Isaiah Yumapig's world, and we're just living in it. 21 points. Are you happy with your senior?
I am happy with it. I mean, but like I said, it's halftime. We got a long way to go.
What do you have to do in the second half to finish this out?
We got to take care of the ball. Obviously, they're going to come out and try to make us turn it over. We got to be strong with it. But then we also got to continue to be aggressive. So.
Perfect. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, Coach.
All right. Thanks, Evan. So he knows there's another half to play. He knows it's hard to maintain a lead. Remember, they had to come from behind to beat Chicago State in the quarterfinals last night. 34-18 our score. Seattle U on top of the Kangaroos.
This copyrighted telecast of the Western Athletic Conference may not be retransmitted, reproduced, or rebroadcast without the express written consent of the WAC Digital Network.
We pursue excellence in the classroom and strive to achieve our potential. We compete on the field with integrity, on the court with respect,
and in the pool with distinction.
We are strong leaders in our community and gain values from our biggest fans.
We continue the legacy of commitment to our universities, to our coaches, to our teammates, and most importantly to you.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community. A tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
People talk about college like you're in some kind of bubble. Like there's college and then there's the real world. Hey, this is UVU. You're not just reading about it or watching someone else do it. This is engaged learning. At the certificate, associates, bachelor's, or master's level, you're in the real world every day.
They are the dreamers and the promise of the future. They are the hope who will lead us to tomorrow. They are the givers who have the passion to serve. They are the visionaries who will celebrate discovery. They will make a difference. They will change South Texas.
Let's check it out.
WAC Student Athletic Advisory Committee partnered with Spread the Word at Wynn Elementary School in Las Vegas, where students from Seattle U and Bakersfield treated the children to a reading of Salt in His Shoes by Michael Jordan.
Spread the Word Nevada is really excited because we partnered up with the WAC Student Athletic Conference group as well as CCSD, and we're providing 2,000 books to two elementary schools today in honor of the WAC being in town and supporting literacy in Nevada.
For children, it just means a lot, like, to let them know early on that education is very important, and me as being a student athlete, you have to read, get your schoolwork done in order to be on the court.
The students enjoyed a performance by the Seattle U band and cheerleaders and spent some time with Rudy the Red Hawk to complete the day.
I have loved it, and I think the main reason I really enjoyed it is because we talk to our children every day about how important college is, how important it is to go to school. But hearing it from people that the kids, they kind of idolize basketball players, they love the drummers, love the cheerleaders, and to hear it from people that are in college and saying, you know, this is me and this is how I got here and how important reading is, it's going to inspire our children to continue.
I know the kids had a lot of fun, and even I learned to cheer from the Seattle U cheer team, and I think I'm going to start putting salt in my shoes as well. You guys will be right back after break. Seattle U up on UMKC 34-18.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that.
Well, did you know certain cartoon characters should never have an energy drink?
Action.
Geico.
For years, Chicago State University has been committed to academic excellence. The conveniently located campus is affordable, accredited, boasts a 15-to-1 student-to-faculty ratio, graduates the largest number of African Americans attending Illinois public universities, and offers a variety of academic programs, including our renowned College of Pharmacy. We also have an outstanding NCAA Division I athletics program. To apply, visit csu.edu.
Christian education with the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu/value.
Discover something new at New Mexico State University, where students find themselves, who they are, and what they want to be. Find new champions, new experiences, new challenges, new opportunities, and horizons. What will you discover at NMSU? Dedicated professors, the perfect college experience. Make lifelong friends and lasting memories. New Mexico State University, all about discovery. Apply today at nmsu.edu. That's nmsu.edu.
They come for one of the nation's top-rated business schools, the world-class performing arts, the advances in engineering and health science, and more than 125 leading degree programs. Their paths to success go in many directions, but they all start here. UMKC, the place for people going places.
Seattle U up on UMKC 34-18. Seattle U's senior Isaiah Umapig with 7 three-pointers, 21 points. We will be back with much more after the break.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that.
Well, did you know that words really can hurt you?
Jason, don't go!
Geico. It all comes down to this. 14 teams battle their way through the bracket for a chance to punch their ticket to the big dance. Be a part of the madness in Las Vegas, March 11th to 14th. Go all in and witness who goes home a champion at Orleans Arena. The 2015 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. Tickets on sale now at OrleansArena.com. In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community. A tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
Talk about college like you're in some kind of bubble. Like there's college and then there's the real world. Hey, this is UVU. You're not just reading about it or watching someone else do it. This is engaged learning. At the certificate, associates, bachelor's, or master's level, you're in the real world every day.
They are the dreamers. And the promise of the future. They are the hope who will lead us to tomorrow. They are the givers who have the passion to serve. They are the visionaries who will celebrate discovery. They will make a difference. They will change South Texas.
Respect for your opponents, the officials, and the fans.
Good sportsmanship is winning with class and losing with dignity. It's fair play, perseverance, and team spirit.
Good sportsmanship is what unites us. We are the Western Athletic Conference.
We pursue excellence in the classroom and strive to achieve our potential. We compete on the field with integrity, on the court with respect,
and in the pool with distinction.
We are strong leaders in our community and gain values from our biggest fans.
We continue the legacy of commitment to our universities, to our coaches, to our teammates, and most importantly to you.
Learn, compete, and inspire.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
It all comes down to this. 14 teams battle their way through the bracket for a chance to punch their ticket to the big dance. Be a part of the madness in Las Vegas, March 11th to 14th. Go all in and witness who goes home a champion at Orleans Arena. The 2015 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. Tickets on sale now at OrleansArena.com.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that.
Well, did you know certain cartoon characters should never have an energy drink?
Action.
Geico. Welcome back inside the Orleans Arena. Halftime score 34-18. UMKC leading the Kangaroos. And that first half, an impressive exhibition of shooting by one Isaiah Yumapig.
And Yumapig here knocking down threes left and right. 7 for 8 behind the line. Just unconscious. Having a great game today. Really leading his team to be up by
34-18. I mean, his stroke is so pure. If you look at it here, pump fake, still having the strength to get that up there, letting everybody know that, hey, I'm on fire. Then that wasn't enough. He had to come back and come off the screen and knock another one down. Total domination by Yuen Peng here, just, you know, leading his team, being a leader. I mean, just amazing stuff coming from this young player here. You know, Kansas City has to find some answers this second half if they want to get back in the game.
Seven made threes by Yuma Pig. He is one shy of tying the WAC tournament record set back in 1997 when Jamel Muhammad, 8 of 11 against SMU back in 97. So he's got one to tie, two to beat. So he could be witnesses to history here tonight in Las Vegas. Seattle U shooting 57% from the field. UMKC, we knew it was going to be a struggle for them, but 26.9%, that's tough to get it done.
Well, KC doesn't have anything to lose. Down big going into the second half. This is a good time for them to come back, add some pressure to the game, because, you know, Seattle is may come out a little complacent, saying, hey, we have the lead, let's just sit on the lead. So this is a good chance for KC to get back by pressuring Seattle, trying to get some steals and some buckets and just get this lead down to a manageable game.
I'm very curious the first 2 minutes, the type of energy UMKC will play with. I think that'll determine if they can get back into this. They have a hard time scoring, but I just think with their defense, they can get some good looks.
Oh, great play there by Cameron Dollar, faking a handoff. There the Union Pig, more than most of the attention is going to be on him.
Actually, with some good production in the first 20 minutes. Cook inside. You know, Jeff Cook had four assists in that first half.
I mean, he's a skillful big man there. You see him taking his time able to finish over Kansas City.
He's now got 4 points to go along with those four assists. So at a halftime, Kangaroos on offense. What did they come up with? Here is Deshaun Taylor back outside to Williams.
You see they struggle in a half-court game. Getting inside that zone. It's a stingy zone that Seattle U plays. Then you got to deal with Crook on the backside of that zone. So great defensive concept from Cameron Dollar. You see here, Casey trying to get in the lane. Great pass inside. Able to finish.
Reese Holiday, the captain of this team. And that's a nice way for the Kangaroos to start. A couple of inside looks to Holiday. He's undersized for 6'4", but he does have that frame where he can take some of that contact.
Reese Holiday is going to be one of the main key factors in getting Kansas City back in this game on the offensive end. Multi-talented. A player can do a variety of different things. Step out and shoot the three. Go inside. Bang a little bit in there. They're going to need him to step up big here in the second half.
Holiday 4 points. Picked up his second personal foul. Both teams now with one team foul.
See Martez Harrison face guarding Yuma Pig right now. Trying not to let him get the ball. Has to be a strategy implemented by Coach Richardson after Yuma Pig hit those 7 threes in the first half.
And the sophomore said, he's holding me. I'm not holding him, the senior. Maybe kind of the crafty veteran getting away with one. Crook lost it going up. Got a pass.
Wow.
Nifty pass to Murray. Here's Floyd down the lane. Got the finish.
Crook might have tipped that on the basket. The referee had a great look at it, but obviously no penalty.
Well, it looked like Cook was going to touch it, but I thought he withheld and thought that was just a good shot by the Red Hawks. He's going off the back of the iron.
Martez Harrison just can't get on the ball. Still haven't made a field goal in this game, only 1 point.
And he's playing with three fouls. 18-point game.
Great defense by Kansas City, swarming the ball.
Got to cut into this deficit.
Nice patience by Seattle U. Shot clock running down.
Murray, they're not going to get a shot off. Oh, Unipic does. Hits the side of the rim, and Holiday comes up with a rebound. Great. I thought for sure they wouldn't get a shot off there.
Great defense by Kansas City. They need to capitalize on that defensive stop. Try to get back in this ball game.
Holiday. Boy, that is tough to turn around and look at 6'10".
That's a tough defense. Not many places to go in that zone. Holiday.
Deck shot and hits the three.
He's so multi-talented. He's a true baller, man. He can play. He can knock down threes. Tough inside. Great heart. Great determination.
Got a quick five here in the second half. 38-23 in the second semifinal. And the winner will face New Mexico State. They have now won 12 in a row. And I saw Villanova, they won earlier today. Villanova, they're second in the country with the amount of wins. And then Duke was struggling late. So maybe New Mexico State will have that record on the, by themselves.
Thing, unusual substitution here. Coach Richardson subbing out all four players, only leaving Harrison on the floor. We're only 4 minutes into the second half. I mean, obviously, he's trying to create some new energy on the floor and keep new bodies, but very early substitution by Coach Richardson.
Chibagu. Out of bounds, it'll stay with the Redhawks.
Kansas City playing better defense this half, not allowing those three-point makes by Unipic, defending the three-point line a little bit better this half. Let's see if they can get another stop so they can continue to cut into this huge Seattle lead.
Nice look inside. Vogel unable to finish. Poor there with the defense, but I think he got a piece of him. And the foul is going to be on the sophomore.
Got to be able to have second and third efforts. Here, see how Unipic does a great job of driving, dishing it down low. Going up strong there.
So Manny Chibago at the line. Misses on the first. At a shoreline Washington, 6'6", 205 sophomore guard is Powell. William Powell comes into the ball game, and we're going to see Holiday at the next possible moment. He'll check in now.
Coach Richardson teamed up with Coach Dollar's substitution pattern. Both teams now going small, trying to speed this game up, get some turnovers so Kansas City can get back in this game.
Harrison 0 for 7 from the field.
Again, Seattle U stuck in his zone. They're going to make you earn it. they're definitely going to make you earn it. You're going to have to shoot them out of the zone. They're a tough team to play against if you get down by a lot of points, because then they get to sit in that zone.
Jennings with that big drive.
Great job by Jennings.
Alan Jennings has played for his dad in high school. Two games due to injury. Powell gets all the way, but misses the layup.
Kansas City just has to play harder. You know, there's no reason Powell, who's playing center right now in Seattle U, should be able to take the ball the length of the court going for a layup and not only miss the layup to get his own basket, but again, great move by Powell here. Going the length of the court, missing the layup and staying with it, overpowering Kansas City in for the layup. Can't win.
Good sportsman. sportsmanship isn't defined by a scoreboard.
It isn't defined by how high you jump or how fast you can run.
Good sportsmanship is all about character.
It is about doing your best for your coaches and teammates.
It is about having respect for your opponents, the officials, and the fans.
Good sportsmanship is winning with class and losing with dignity.
It's fair play, perseverance, and team spirit.
Good sportsmanship is what unites us. We are the Western Athletic Conference.
People talk about college like you're in some kind of bubble. Like there's college and then there's the real world. Hey, this is UVU. You're not just reading about it or watching someone else do it. This is engaged learning. At the certificate, associates, bachelor's, or master's level, you're in the real world every day.
So there's time, but the Red Hawks have been the better team so far in this game against the Kangaroos. And, you know, and part of the game, as you mentioned, but they have lost 80-plus games, speaking of UMKC, due to injuries.
Wow.
And I think we're kind of seeing it running down here.
Absolutely. But you have to give it up to Seattle. You extremely well-coached team. Looks like you came into this game extremely prepared. Coach Dollar, a great teacher of the game, great motivator, allowing his players to have the confidence to come out here to put on this type of performance here in the semifinals.
We talked about Kareem Richardson and how, you know, Patino helped mentor him. How about Lorenzo Romar,
right,
for Cameron Dollar at St. Louis and then at University of Washington?
Played against Lorenzo Romar's teams while I was at DePaul. Played against St. Louis. Always had very tough teams. Very well coached, fundamentally sound teams. We're seeing that here with Coach Dollar.
Okay, so next 4 minutes. See if UMKC can cut into this. Vince Austin was fouling the play. A freshman from Centerville, Illinois.
We see Kansas City trying to get inside that zone, doing a good job of getting the ball to the middle of the floor, trying to create some things in the heart of the zone.
Harrison. They have got to get him a good look somehow. Give him some confidence back. Jennings. Here's Austin. Goes right at Crook. That is tough to score against.
Yeah, right now Kansas City's run out of options. They're guessing on offense. Can't get anything going to the basket. They're going to have more movement, more screens. Try to do something to counter this stifling zone of Seattle U.
It was deflected. Chiboygo looking inside to Kohi, and now coming in will be Thaddeus Smith. Had 7 blocks in the game earlier this year against Indiana State, which tied a school record.
Great block by Smith.
And he's still down, by the way, Smith. Oh, he's hopping on one leg. Crook.
If you're Crook, you got to go up and dunk that. You know, you get your shot blocked twice in there because you're trying to lay it up soft off the glass. I'm a big believer in this. You have an open lane here. You try one layup. Now you got to gather yourself and go up and
Murray gets it to Yumapeg to tie the record. It's going to be short. And Holly comes up with it. There's Taylor. I like this lineup here for Coach Richardson.
And Harrison trying to do whatever he can to get yourself involved in this game, going in, drawing a foul. But you have to love the aggressiveness there instead of settling for a jump shot, going in, driving the lane. Now he's at the foul line, shooting two free throws.
10th Kangaroo to score over 1,000 points. Fourth quickest in program history. 58 games. Just a tremendous offensive player now as Powell comes in. And Chibago sits out for Coach Dollar.
One shot, Devin. Here we go. Straight in,
huh? One more coming up for the WAC Player of the Year. As well as Noah Knight.
So we have more substitutions for Kansas City. Coach Richardson loves to run guys in and out of the game, keep fresh bodies on the floor. I believe they're going to ramp up their pressure even more starting now, trying to get back to the ball game.
Yeah, they need to create a storm of distraction, as Coach Cameron Dollar would call it. I don't know if they've got that energy to do that, as the both teams played yesterday. Powell does not roll in. Harrison comes up with it.
Great move by Powell, just unable to finish, but a great look.
Rocking call, and so the captain, Reese Hardy, will go to the free throw line.
That's what Kansas City needs to do. Create missed shots here. Get the ball to Holiday here. Pump fake, driving to the lane hard. The great thing about that possession is they didn't allow that zone to set up. If you can get Seattle U to miss some shots, push the ball down the floor, you'll have better attempts in your early offense.
Powell picks up just his first personal foul. And Holiday with 7 points. Playing with three fouls, has three rebounds. First free throws of the night. Makes good on the first.
Harrison, a very consistent performer, comes to play every night, inside, outside. Performer, he can handle what he's having so far.
As Holiday knocks him down, and Smith comes back in. Boy, they
seems
really rotated, haven't they?
It seems Coach Richardson is having an offensive, defensive approach. So Smith in for defense. Keeping Holiday on the floor for offense. He's going to run guys in and out the whole night. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at Seattle U, trying to get back in his game. Cut the lead down here to 12 points, so they're in striking distance if they can continue to get stops.
Led by as many as 19. And now I'm not quite sure what this discussion is. I know he wanted a turnover. Speaking of Coach Richardson, didn't get it. And difference of opinion, no doubt, with Coach Richardson and our official.
Running guys in and out of the game, trying to get things set up. Get the right group of players on the floor.
To inside the court.
Very aggressive, trying to get a steal.
A 10-second call. So there's a turnover created because of that pressure. And can they get points off of it?
Kansas City is going to try to junk up the game now. Just play relentless pressure. They have let the lead down 12, 13 minutes to play. Going to try to do anything to get themselves back in this game.
That's now 10 turnovers. And just 3 points off of turnovers for UMKC. It's 18 a game. And it's deep three by Taylor.
Now ramping up the pressure. They're going to turn everything around.
This is exactly what Coach Dollar was concerned about.
Together by the Kangaroos.
Unipig to tie the record. Mitchell Davidson. for two in this half. After he was 7 for 11 in the first.
Kansas City really picking up pressure now. Taylor can make that.
How about Murray skying for that rebound?
Great look at it by Taylor. Hit the back rim. From my angle, it was right on line. Looked good to me. Got the bad bounce and missed the shot.
I mean, that was deep, but he made one that was almost as deep just moments ago. And boy, did that give some energy and life to the Kangaroos.
He did, just cut the lead down to 9 points. Now they're starting to slow the game down a little bit. Get back in the game here. See what Seattle U can do to combat that.
Emerson Murray, the senior guard, a transfer from Cal out of Vancouver, British Columbia. Made that key defensive stop and game sealing free throws against that pesky Chicago State team. And the ball game. And back to double figures for Seattle U.
Martez Harrison hit the ball over the game, trying to extend every second off the clock. He can get up the ball. Martez Harrison finally gets him off the floor. First field goal of the game, 1 for 8. That has to feel good to get that first one to fall. Let's see if he can get some confidence up there to finish the game off strong.
He's got 6 points. Yumapig.
Yumapig has to drive the basket. He's missed a few shots now. Still want to get him involved offensively.
And Williams Jr.
Kansas City's defense is relentless right now.
Yumapig with a pretty teardrop. First shot other than a three to go in.
Smooth down there. Great footwork. Great offensive player. Just knows how to use different angles to get to the basket. Wonderful player for the Seattle U team.
He's got 23 points here tonight.
All right, we see Yumapig wheeling and dealing. Getting in. Might have took an extra step there, but hey, who saw that? Great bucket for Seattle.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that.
Well, did you know that words really can hurt you?
Jason, don't go!
Geico.
They come for one of the nation's top-rated business schools, the world-class performing arts, the advances in engineering and health science, and more than 125 leading degree programs. Their paths to success go in many directions, but they all start here. UMKC, the place for people going places.
They are the dreamers and the promise of the future. They are the hope who will lead us to tomorrow. They are the givers who have the passion to serve. They are the visionaries who will celebrate discovery. They will make a difference. They will change South Texas.
So UMKC showing some signs. That defense has led to some turnovers and some points. Able to knock down a couple of threes. It's got them back into this game, and they're believing now they can make a bit of a run here in the semifinals.
Great job of Kansas City coming out with more aggressiveness this half, really feeling a sense of urgency, being down by as much as 19. Now they're pushing their defense up, getting in the face of Seattle U, not allowing those easy three-point shots like they allowed in the first half. Only down by 10 with 11:26 left. We have a lot of basketball to play, and Kansas City has a bit of momentum going into the second half.
Now, without question, is Frank Williams Jr. inbounds it to Noah Knight. And Harrison able to make his first bucket just moments ago with 6 points. Knight attacks the lane. His
Great hustle.
And Jennings knocks it away. Like the idea that time by Seattle U to be aggressive with it.
Great idea by Seattle U, throw it over top of the pressure to Flora. As you see here, going over top of the zone. Great hustle there by Jennings, but, you know, even a better idea for Coach Cameron's team to try to go up top of that zone, try to get an easy bucket instead of dealing with all that trapping pressure down on this other end.
Well, we have a second here as the winner of this game, of course, will face New Mexico State in the championship game. It'll be tomorrow, 8 o'clock. On ESPNU, and the Aggies have now won 12 in a row, and one of the highest teams in the country. I'm not sure what's going on with Duke. They were trailing the last that I saw, but they were tied with Duke with the third longest active winning streak in the country right now. I know Villanova did win in their conference tournament, barely by 2 points. They're number two. And of course, I don't know if anybody's going to catch Kentucky.
No, I don't think so. Not with that undefeated record. But New Mexico State, very talented team. They play, you know, five guys that all play with confidence on the floor, which what you love to see. Your coach instilling confidence in all the guys. Very big team. They play a front court of 6'8", 6'9", 6'10". And their fans are just incredible. As you see in the first game here, they packed this place and had it rocking. Here is just a very talented group. It's going to be an interesting game to see in the final round of the championship.
No question, the attendance will be terrific for the finals, as both Aggies, the men and the women, both have made it. And I expect this to be pretty full tomorrow afternoon and evening.
Absolutely.
Texas Pan American will face the women Aggies. They had a remarkable comeback against Bakersfield, the two seed, earlier today. And that game, I believe, is 1 o'clock Pacific time, also seen on ESPNU, as Flora makes the first free throw. One more coming up from the Bremerton, Washington native. Missed it. And Holiday clears.
All right, just a 9-point lead for Seattle. Let's see if Kansas City can get a good possession here. Cut this lead down even more. You can tell that they are playing with more confidence, playing quicker, playing faster, moving a lot better than they did in the first half.
Need another shot to go down. That would ramp up the energy on defense that much more. Here's Jennings. Tough contested shot. Brooke. And actually, I guess Flora comes up with it.
Again, that zone is tough. You know, they play with guys who know where to be. They make very few mental errors on defense, which makes that zone so effective.
Seattle U, two of their last 11 from the floor. They were shooting at 1.57%. Flora inside. Chance for a three-point play for Jarrell Flora.
Just a great move by Flora. Frank Williams, Colin Jennings has to play better defense than that. Obviously, he's going to go have a seat. Coach Richardson not happy with that effort, but Flora, just a great move. Going to the basket, getting the and one.
Flora makes good on that three-point play. And UMKC in trouble now, 49-37, as we are inside now, 10 minutes to go.
Seems like every time Kansas City tries to get back in the game, Seattle U responds with a big play.
Knight. Williams Jr. Controlled by Flora.
Seattle U doing a great job of defensive rebounding, not giving Kansas City extra possessions. One shot done, mostly to Kansas City.
Yeah, that's a quality point. They're plus 10 rebounds, speaking of Seattle U. Yuma Pig. selfishly, I'd like to see the record tonight. Powell underneath. Shadows on this. Here's Crook.
There it is.
Is this number 8 front rim? Williams Jr. with the rebound up to Harrison. Martez. Boy, again, Shadow set up in this zone is Holiday has to go back out.
Kansas City's trying to push the ball down the floor before Seattle U can get back in that zone. But Coach Dow's team does an excellent job in transition of getting back to a zone. You don't see that much. Team doing a great of getting back to a transition. Most of the time they get back to a man-to-man. But if you get back to a zone, that's very impressive to do.
Green does not fall by Harrison. Boy, that would have been big. He's hit 1 3-pointer here tonight. And again, they seem stuck at 37. Ball lost it, but Murray able to track it down before it goes out. Umepig on a drive. Oh, nice speed inside the power. Great assist by Umepig.
Great execution. Started out with a great screen. And Umepig to drive down the lane, finding power for the easy bucket.
UMKC, they have not scored in about 3 minutes. And a whistle and a foul on Murray. On the Harrison drive.
Here's Seattle executing on offense. Great screen there. Hard drive. Great dish to Powell. This is great execution. Very fundamentally sound Cameron Dollar team.
Nice feed. Harrison to Holiday.
Good job. Harrison getting in the lane. Finding an open man.
Set up this defense, this pressure. But Powell, how about the big fella handling the basketball?
Great versatility, great weapon for Cameron Dollar to have a guy like Powell come in and handle the ball against pressure like that.
51-39, 7.5. Here in this ball game, Umepig, the dribble got away with him a couple times. Gets it to floor in the lane. Oh, good on shot. Now, Seattle U, Powell able to finish.
Great job of using the rim to protect the ball. Up under the basket, great reverse layup. Powell's a very skilled player near the basket.
Without question, a foul on the Holiday drive.
Powell here doing a great job, both handling the ball, helping out, doing pressure. Just a very versatile player. Nice reverse layup there. Just having an excellent second half.
Christian education with the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu/value.
Discover something new at New Mexico State University, where students find themselves, who they are, and what they want to be. Find new champions, new experiences, new challenges, new opportunities, and horizons. What will you discover at NMSU? Dedicated professors, the perfect college experience. Make lifelong friends and lasting memories. New Mexico State University, all about discovery. Apply today at nmsu.edu. That's nmsu.edu.
Huh, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Hey, I know that.
Well, did you know that former pro football player Icky Woods will celebrate almost anything?
44.
Woo! 44, that's me!
Get some cold cuts.
Geico.
Get some cold.
53-39, Seattle leading UFKC. Perform here at the timeout. The last play. We'll talk about that as we went to break. selfishness of Seattle U, as there is Cameron Dollar with Yuma Pig.
Absolutely. You see here, Flores driving the lane. William Powell doing an excellent job with the reverse layup. Very versatile player. Outstanding around the block. Great play.
Assists, by the way, by Seattle U. They have done a nice job sharing the ball. Taylor. For the freshman out of Kansas.
Great look by Taylor. He's had a few that's in and out. He needs to keep shooting the ball because he has a nice rhythm. Those shots are going to eventually fall.
Knight now with 4 points after that made bucket inside. And he does get 3 points on that possession.
Kansas City staying within striking distance, allowing this lead to stay under 15. With that pressure, anything can happen.
And here is he an upset in trouble. Murray able to help him out.
Relentless pressure here by Kansas City.
And they certainly need all of that in the last 6:40 to get back into this game. Unipig.
Nice screen by Cook.
Missed down the three. And a foul is going to be on Smith.
Unipig a little off this half. I think he's gotten a little three happy. He needs to drive the lane, create open opportunities for his teammates. See if he can get an open one instead of one off the dribble. I think that'll help his shot out a lot.
21 first half points, only two in the second half.
But Kansas City has did a nice job on him, containing him, making him work for his shots, trapping him off screens, making things difficult. But Seattle U has still found ways to score. Leading by 12 points.
Crook now 7 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists, and playing with 3 fouls. Taylor, a blocking call. Powell thought he was there, but Deshaun Taylor is going to head to the free throw line.
Looked like he was there at this angle, but referee had a good look at it. May have been still sliding his feet. Kansas City going to the line, trying to get this lead back down to 10.
Taylor, a very good free throw shooter at one part in the season, had hit 22 in a row.
Wow.
Taking some time, though, with this free throw. Oh, because perspiration didn't see that. The ball boy out there mopping it up. And he missed. So, one of the top free throw shooters misses that first one. One more coming up is Frank Williams Jr. Comes back into the game.
Well, Kansas City set their defense up again. Hasn't got as many turnovers as they would like this second half. But they're still trying. They're still fighting. Seattle U has done a terrific job of beating this pressure.
Yeah, just 9 turnovers.
Kansas City relies heavily on turnovers. Just haven't been able to turn Seattle U over as much as they would like.
Now they want that figure to be doubled. They're looking for 18, 19, 20. They had 28 earlier this season. That's a huge part of that offense. They average about 18 points off of those turnovers.
Huge.
Flora with 2 seconds.
Big shot by Flora. Shot clock running down. He can square it up and knock it down.
He now has 13 points on 4 of 7 shooting. Scoring with 3 rebounds. Harrison got in the lane. Too strong, even though he's not been there.
He's frustrated. You know, he's getting open looks. He just doesn't have the touch. This whole tournament just can't make shots. one for 10, 6 points, four fouls.
Gives up to Yumapig. Taylor on him defensively. And he walks with it. So the 10th turnover. Let's see if it will lead to points here for UMKC. Yeah, Yumapig had that spectacular first half. Very difficult to match anything remotely close to that. He has tried to get his teammates a little bit more involved here in the second half, but he does not have the same kind of performance.
It is, but you know, you have to credit the Kansas City defense. They came out the second half keen on him, trapping the pick and roll more, getting out on his shots. Fortunate enough, you know, Seattle has just played great as a team. It's been a team effort here in the second half for Seattle U.
So Harrison back at the free throw line. Nobody shot more free throws in the WAC than Martez. Makes good on the first. Colin Jennings comes back into the game as Austin goes out. Down both free throws.
Kansas City had a hard time getting this game under double figures. Cracking to this lead of Seattle U. They've been cruising the second half. Every time Kansas City makes a run, Seattle U comes right back with a big bucket. Exactly, they can't convert. You know, Seattle U's have a perfect balance of big shots and big defensive stops over Kansas City. This has to be extremely frustrating for Coach Richardson's group.
He's done a nice job with this program, though, to get them to a two seed as Harrison slid after missing the ball on that pass to about the three-point line. Yumapig.
Wow.
Ties the WAC tournament record with his 8th-3.
That was a big shot. You know, just perfect execution by the Seattle U team. Very patient, running shot clock down, wasting clock. Come out with a big three there at the end.
Taylor missing on the teardrop.
Now Kansas City has to make something happen here. Get late in the game, 3:20 left. Down 14. Seattle, you just not allowing Kansas City to go on that run. Here, Cameron Dollar with the timeout. He knows that he can smell the victory. He can smell that championship game. So they want to make sure this is a good possession for his team. As you see here, you're the pick. Just giving it up, gets it back. He's behind a three-point line, draining a great shot.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
For years, Chicago State University has been committed to academic excellence. The conveniently located campus is affordable, accredited, boasts a 15-to-1 student-to-faculty ratio, graduates the largest number of African Americans attending Illinois public universities, and offers a variety of academic programs, including our renowned College of Pharmacy. We also have an outstanding NCAA Division I athletics program. To apply, visit csu.edu.
59-45, Seattle U on top. Again, this alignment to get into Yumapig. Moments ago set the, or tied the WAC tournament record with most threes made in a tournament game with 8. With Muhammad of Colorado State back in 97 set that against SMU. And another turnover. This, it might be a little too late. But, foul. The clock is stopped. Chance to get points at the free throw line.
Kansas City is scrappy. They're going to try to give it one last heroic effort. Let's see how this last 252 plays out.
59-45 on top.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community. A tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
For years, Chicago State University has been committed to academic excellence. The conveniently located campus is affordable, accredited, boasts a 15-to-1 student-to-faculty ratio, graduates the largest number of African Americans attending Illinois public universities, and offers a variety of academic programs, including our renowned College of Pharmacy. We also have an outstanding NCAA Division I athletics program. To apply, visit csu.edu.
To 45, 252 left. Isaiah Umabik with a historic night tonight in the winning tournament.
26 points, that's on the outstage. You can hear raising up, left and right, all game long. He's relentless, fearless in his offensive attack. This team here to a huge lead in the second half. If he could do this against New Mexico State, I mean, it's going to be a heck of a game. I'm going to be having my popcorn ready to watch that. I mean, New Mexico State is a tough team, a very long, defensive-minded team. So Seattle U is going to have their work cut for them if they end up facing New Mexico State in the championship.
As Deshaun Taylor knocks down the first free throw. Missed one moment ago. That was very rare. He's one of the top free throw shooters. And he hits some balls. So an outside possibility here with 3 minutes. And they try some defense. Maybe a 5 second. No. It's going to be out of bounds. Seattle U basketball. I thought I had heard a whistle. But boy, again, I've heard like 5 whistles that have not been there throughout the course of our coverage. They give to Umapig, who's Powell.
Harassing defense. Way to deal with the pressure by Seattle U. Truly patient, well-coached team.
Now Frank Williams Jr. commits the foul. And more free throws coming up.
Kansas City trying to stretch the game out by fouling, hoping that Seattle, you can go to the line and miss some free throws so they can get some opportunities on the offensive end, try to cut into this lead.
Powell at the line, makes the first. 9 points, 6 rebounds, 2 assists, a block shot, and 34 minutes of work.
Very solid player for Seattle U. Fundamentally sound, great around the basket, versatile, able to do a number of things on the floor. Great asset for Coach Dollar to have a guy like Powell on his roster.
Austin out, Harrison back in. Powell gets the bounce. So now double figures. UMKC, one of the last 5, although that one goes in. And Richardson calls for a timeout. They have one left. Seattle U has one timeout left.
Nice move by Taylor. Basket, great body control. Nice lay-in.
This is our 10th and final game here on the WAC Digital Network for the WAC Tournament. I'd like to thank our guys that have worked so hard in the last 3 days. Robbie and Trevor, Bob, Doug, Larry, Juan, Wade, and Lane. It's not easy to work 10 games in 3 days, but our guys have certainly done a nice job. We appreciate all the work that they've done, bringing you these pictures, the sights, and sounds here from Las Vegas.
Absolutely. It's been a pleasure working with you, Mike.
Yeah, our first time.
Sitting next to you all day. It's been great. Thanks for wearing
that. I appreciate that. Hey, I think it's great to be calling this with a former NBA player.
It's
I hang out with a lot of those. So it's been terrific.
It's fun getting out here and calling these games, watching this young talent. The WAC is such great young potential. Years to come, it's great having a tournament here in Vegas.
Absolutely. All the coaches like you. I heard Evan's interview with, of course, the commissioner saying they'll be back here again next season here in Las Vegas. And that's just, again, the coaches seem to love having it here. They love it that it's at a neutral site. As Yuma Pig at the line, makes good on the first. Now 27 for Isaiah Yuma Pig.
This excellent release on this shot. Really takes his time. This is legs into his shot. Great follow through. Textbook jump shot.
Harrison, got to go quickly here. Taylor, I like watching Deshaun Taylor play. Holiday lost it in the paint. And that's a tough thing, is he was surrounded. All five Red Hawks with him in the paint. That's got to be a lonely feeling.
Yes, it is.
Now Holiday, is he going to throw it? No, he's actually going Knight.
You know what? No lack of effort here by Kansas City. Just Seattle U has played a great game. Just nice resolve. Oh, great shot by Taylor.
So Taylor knocks in the three. That is the seventh made three by UMKC.
Frank Williams.
Williams Jr., huh? Hit that last three for the Kangaroos. Here is Holiday doubled over, coming off that 18-point performance in the quarterfinals against Texas Pan American.
Coach Richardson starting his foul game early, 2 minutes to go. Gonna foul every possession. Try to extend this game as long as he can. Get his team the best opportunity to try to come back and win this game.
Pell with 10 points at the line. One more coming up. He's 2 for 3. And he does get the free throw to drop now, making it 64-52, under two to play Harrison. Knight. This is Taylor. And does not get the bounce. But he strikes out his own.
Wow.
On the other. Top 10 worthy. So he missed the three on one side.
Oh,
on the other side. I don't think he was looking at the basket.
Oh, my gosh. I never seen it.
Oh, my. The WAC tournament provided
all
sorts of
he
highlights.
Throws some shooting shot, gets his own rebound, throws it up, and in. I mean, that's going to be on the top 10 plays for years to come. Just a crazy play. Gets his team only down by 9 into single digits. But wow, what an effort. What a shot.
Like I said, I like watching Deshaun Taylor play. What a highlight. Incredible.
I mean, when I first seen it, I said, okay, why is he shooting at the basket? Because they have a new shot clock. So I thought maybe, okay, he passed it. Then I looked again and said, oh, my gosh, this has a chance to go in. And obviously it went in. So just crazy play there. Fortunate enough to make the shot.
Winner's going to be blown up about that shot, no question, by Deshaun Taylor.
Oh,
just pass to the line.
Hang on to the ball there. Get strong and secure the ball.
Well, it's still an outside possibility. I know it's remote, but
let's look at the kid. He misses the shot, then gets his own rebound, then throws.
That is incredible.
I've officially seen it all with that play. Great effort.
Well, that's Twitter's just going to go crazy over that shot. And they should. You have to see that.
Wow.
And that to happen here in the WAC tournament, that is great.
Well, here's the pressure. Lead down to single digits. Let's see if Seattle U can handle this pressure from Kansas City. Have to get it over.
Yuma Pig. Deflected and a turnover. Frank Williams Jr. got it. Down to eight.
This can get interesting.
Misses on the three. Wow, that would have went in. So Seattle U not closing the door on UMKC. And if they get a couple of threes here to fall, they got a chance.
Florian here trying to dribble it up. Loses control of the ball, bounces off his knee. Kansas City has yet another opportunity.
Harrison able to draw the foul on front. They have as many threes as you can as a team, but it's when you hit them. And they've hit them here with under a minute to play.
Kansas City making a crazy flurry here, trying to get back in the game.
Coach Richardson is not giving up despite trailing by 15 points. And they had that incredible three by Taylor moments ago. Kind of get caught up in the absurdity and the improbability of that three going in. But boy, did that help them.
It did.
To get here to single digits. And now Martez Harrison, who's taken more free throws than anybody in the WAC, at the charity stripe. Harrison, it's been frustrating. One of the 11 shooting, but he does have 8 points. And these two free throws coming up can really give this Kangaroo team some momentum.
Again, here's Taylor. Misses the three-point shot. Runs it down. Throws it up. Desperation knocks it down.
I mean, he went from one corner to the other corner. Great hustle.
One of the weirdest plays I've ever seen. It was truly amazing. But here you have Seattle only up six now. Kansas City has put the full court pressure on.
And the ball is trapped in the corner. Murray, nice job getting it to Unipeg.
Got to throw it out. You got to get it over. Might have been 10 seconds. Ooh, almost another turnover.
And Taylor thought he fouled him. He wants the clock to be stopped. They don't want to foul Yuma Pig, but he had to. He thought he had the foul on Powell. That would have, given him a few more seconds at least. Boy, Deshaun Taylor, fun to watch.
He is. Against these teams, you have to finish the game. You know, we saw this earlier in the girls' game, New Mexico State girls versus Texas Pan American, where, you've seen New Mexico State in control, up 10, 4 minutes left in the game, but allowed Texas Pan American to get steals and turnovers. So anything can happen in these final seconds. You have to finish the game, not turn the ball over, and continue to make your free throws.
Seattle U with three turnovers the last little bit, but Yuma Pig at the line. Yeah, boy, just a great evening for the young man out of Federal Way, Washington. Now with 29 points. Got to go quick now if you're UMKC. And Holiday does score quickly, 27 seconds. And this will be the final timeout by UMKC. Still a six-point game, so two possessions. And the turnovers now at 15 for Seattle U. So that has been creeping up.
Just relentless pressure from Kansas City. Refs allowing Kansas City to play a little bit more aggressive back in this game. It's going to be crucial for Seattle U to make his free throws down the stretch and
this in, they can really put the game away. But you have to make your free throws right here.
You got to make your free throws. And right now, Seattle U, they're shooting 68%, 15 of 22 at the charity stripe. Points off turnovers, dead even, 14. And so, UMKC close to their average, 18 points.
Last few minutes of the game, getting turnovers. Wish they could have got some turnovers earlier in the game. We could be calling a different ball game right now, but Seattle U has shot the ball great all night and also not turned the ball over as much as Kansas City would like them to. So great job of Seattle U having the resolve. They're going to try to finish this game out. They can get the ball in bounds, get fouled, knock down some free throws, come down this inning, get a stop, they can wrap this game up.
Can they hang on? And their first tournament win, I think, since sometime in the 60s. Because they've been without a conference for so long, has Seattle U. That is good to get by Chicago State. As Unitech able to beat the pressure, gets it over to Murray. So now Seattle U looking at back-to-back tournament wins. And, we talked, I think, yesterday about the great history and tradition of the Red Hawks with Elgin Baylor beating the Globetrotters. You couldn't get past that. And the fact that they beat West Texas, the only team to beat West Texas here, that the Miners went on to win the national championship. And they beat Kentucky. But a really good history. And then it kind of went away for a while.
They did.
And they reinstated it. And they went through all sorts of divisions. They were played independent for a while. And now they're full status division one.
Great.
Just seconds away from moving up to the finals.
Great. Way to attack the basket. Martez Harrison now getting more aggressive. Wish we would have seen more of this from him early in the game. But now in desperation mode, attacking the basket and getting to the free throw line.
Harrison in double figures, despite 1 of 11 shooting. Playing with 4 fouls. Gets the bounce here. He's playing with 4. Holiday has 4. Taylor has 4. Jennings with 3. Smith with 3. Crunker fouled out on the other side for Seattle U. And he's got them both. It is a 5-point game with 15.2 left. Powell quickly fouled by Jennings, and that's his 4th. And so they've got now 4 with 4. As UMKC, 4 players with 4 fouls. That sends Powell back to the line.
KC doing a nice job of defensive pressure here, but I believe at the end of the game, the score is not going to resemble the dominance that Seattle U had over this game. Here, KC having some desperation flurries at the end of the game. Crazy three-point shot down there, but University of Seattle just played great all day, knocking down shots, being in that zone that frustrated KC all night in the half court. So just an excellent job from Cameron Dollar's squad.
Taylor can go for the quick two. Doesn't get it. Back tap. That shot won't fall. President backed up to try to go for a three. That's the way the game ends. And Seattle U back-to-back tournament wins. First time they've done that since the 60s. And they will advance to face New Mexico State in the finals. 8 o'clock on ESPN. But they win by a score of 69-63. Give UMKC a lot of credit for not giving up, for making this a competitive game at the very end, when nothing was really going their way.
Exactly. It was a tough night for KC. All night trying to deal with the zone of Seattle. Great job of University of Seattle offensively.
University of Seattle.
All right, well, Evan is standing by with Isaiah Yumpig at 30 points. Go ahead, Evan.
Yeah, 30 points tonight and 8 three-pointers. You tied the WAC tournament record. What was it like getting the hot hand?
It felt good. My teammates are finding me in open spots, and I kind of got in the rhythm, and I just tried to carry that on.
You're off to finals. What is your matchup looking like with New Mexico State?
It's looking great. Team, they're big and physical, and we're gonna have to lock down. And we played 2 days in a row, and they've only played one, but we're gonna have to not lock down if we want to get this one done.
Good luck in the finals, Isaiah.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Back to you guys.
All right, Evan. Thank you. Very nice to work with you over the stretch the last 3 days, the 10 games. Okay, so assess, Steven, this final that's coming up tomorrow on ESPNU at 8 o'clock.
It's going to be a great game. We've got two great defenses here. I'm interested to see how Mexico State matches up against the tough zone of Seattle U. Should be an interesting game. If Yumpig can stay hot like he did tonight, I mean, this is going to be a close game.
Now, Seattle U did beat New Mexico State in Seattle by a score of 58-52, but the Aggies did not have Daniel Mullins, and he is a major difference maker. Well, we would like to thank you for watching this WAC Digital Network production of the 2015 WAC Basketball Tournament. Our final score, Seattle U 69, UMKC 63 for our executive producer, Robbie, for our director, Trevor.